In this tutorial, we will be learning the very basics of Photoshop from the very first time you open it. Before we get started, don't forget to hit subscribe and turn on your notifications. Hello everyone! In this tutorial, we are covering the very basics of Adobe Photoshop. So from the first time you open it, we will cover how to open an image, how to create a new document, how to save a document, how to select tools, the top bar menus, and what are panels, and how to add new panels. So let's get started with number one, open an image. When you open Photoshop CC, this is the screen that will be displayed. It's the workspace, and it gives you access to all your recent files. So you can see all these thumbnails of your recent documents. So you can click on one of them to open it, or if it's your first time and you don't have recent files, you can see like the open button, create new button. And it's innovative compared to the previous versions of Photoshop. So, to open an image, either click on the Open button on the left side or go to File, Open. Use the window that appears to browse through your files. So, select the image you would like to open, and once you've selected it, just click on the Open button. So the existing file will now be opened in Photoshop. Number two, create a new document. Okay, now let's learn how to create a new document. So you either go on the Create New button or go to File, New. When the window appears, go to the Preset Details. And where it says Untitled, you can insert the name that you want to give your file. Then choose the unit that you want to use. Sometimes I use centimeters, sometimes I use pixels, it depends. So choose your unit. And then insert the dimensions that you want to give your file. Or you can choose one of the presets. Enter the resolution. There are still a few other options, like the color mode and the advanced options, that we will probably cover in a future video. And then there's the background color, which I'm just going to stick with white. When you are finished, go down to the Create button and click on it. Your new document is created. Number three, save a document. So now to save your document, go to File, Save As, and a new window will open. Here, you can either leave the original name you gave your document when you created it, or rename it with a different name. And more importantly, choose the file type. Photoshop supports many types of image files. So, as you can see from the drop-down menu, there is JPEG, there is TIFF, PNG, there is Photoshop document, there are a lot of image file types. We will go through these file types more specifically in the next video. So, for example, I'm going to save this document, even though there's nothing on it, as a PSD, meaning a Photoshop document. So now I'm going to close it, and when I go to File, Open, you see the icon of a PSD. I click on it, open, and here's the file I had saved. Number four, select tools. Okay, let's go quickly over the Photoshop tools. So here on the left side, you can see add these presetted tools. You can move them wherever you want. So like I drag them onto my document, you can leave them on the left where they were, you can like position them where it's more comfortable. So I'm gonna zoom in so you can see them better. Okay, so first of all, Photoshop has all these different types of tools. And then we can see that most of them have this little arrow on the bottom right corner. This is because Photoshop groups similar tools. So if you go on one of the icons with this little arrow and you click and hold, you can see that this little menu comes up that shows all the tools that are in that group, meaning that they're basically similar. So actually there's a lot more tools than the ones we see. To select a tool, all you have to do is click on it. Okay, so I'm just going to drag the tools and snap them back onto the left side of the screen. As you can see, when that blue line comes up, that means it's going to snap it to the side. Number 5, top bar menus. All of Photoshop's tools and commands are grouped in these menus on the top bar. So if you click on one of them, you can see that these are drop-down menus. So each one of them has many like options, tools, commands. Number 6, panels. After learning the left side tools and the top bar menus, now we have the right side panels and windows. Let's start with these panels on the very right. Okay, these ones, as the tools, are divided in groups. Only here, there are no hidden tabs. You can see all the tabs that are part of the group, okay? For example, in this group, we have 3 tabs, which is layers, channels, and paths. Then we have this other row of panels. These are little tabs, but if you click on them, they become panels. And these are divided in groups as well. They could be groups, they can be single. This one, for example, has 2 tabs in this group. So when you open the panel, you can see the 2 tabs. And if it's closed, you can see the group as well, because groups are divided by this little line. Okay, these 2 rows, even though this first row has windows and the second one is little icons, they are all the same category of panels. If I press on these 2 little arrows on the top right corner, collapse to icons, you can see that these windows close into little icons just like the other row. Or if I press on the 2 arrows on the top of the row with the icons, it will expand the panels so they look like the bigger panels on the right side. Now that we've established that all of these panels are part of the same category, we can go on to saying that these can be customized and reorganized as you wish. You can reorganize tabs that are in the same group by dragging them and reorganizing the order. Or you can drag a tab into a different group by dragging it into the other group. And also you can move a whole group by moving it in between 2 groups, or adding the whole group to another group and making it one group. You can also separate a group from the row by dragging it and positioning it wherever you like on the screen. You can can also just separate a single tab instead of separating the whole group and position it where it's more useful for you. You can create like a new row just by snapping it onto the edge, or as we said before, you can add it to one of the existing groups. Well, you can pretty much personalize it as it best suits you. Number 7, add panel. So that being said, let's go on to our last info of the video, and that is timeline, and this will add the timeline panel. It added it on the bottom. So to remove the timeline panel, I just go back to window, press it again, the check will be removed, and the panel will be removed as well. So what I said is valid for all the other panels on the right side. Okay, so you can add them and remove them just by using the window menu. So this was the very basic information for someone that opens Adobe Photoshop for the very first time. I hope all this information was useful and that you subscribe and stay tuned for more videos.